Bwana Yesu apewe sifa and glory be to the name of the Lord. He has given us yet another chance so that we can dine on his divine table. Once again, Leverett Kiboy, I invite you to another moment of sharing or having a fellowship together with our God through his word. The message of today, I hope just like the rest, it will be a blessing to you as the Lord has ordained it to be. It comes from the book of John chapter number 11, verse 1 through to 9. You remember the last time we had another message also from the book of John, because John is a wonderful gospel writer. So I'll read from John chapter number 11, verse 1 through to 9. The Bible says, "Now a certain man was sick, named Lazarus of Bethany, the town of Mary, her sister Martha." Number two, "It was that Mary which anointed the Lord with anointment and wiped his feet with her hair, whose brother Lazarus was sick." Number three, "Therefore his sister sent unto him, saying, Lord, behold, he whom thou lovest is sick." Number four, "When Jesus heard that, he said, This sickness is not unto death, but for the glory, that the Son of God might be glorified thereby." Number five, "Now Jesus loved Martha and her sister and Lazarus." Number six, "When he heard therefore that he was sick, he abode 2 days still in the same place where he was. Then after that said to his disciples, Let us go into Judea." He's to Judea again. Number eight, "His disciples said unto him, Master, the Jews of late sought to stone thee, and you go there again? Jesus answered, Are there not 12 hours in the day? If any man walk in the day, he stumbleth not, because he sees the light of this world." Thank you, Lord, for your word. May you use it to minister unto our spirits tonight. And it is in Jesus' name we pray and offer thanks. Amen. Today, there is a message that the Lord has for us, and it is entitled, "The Marks of True Friendship." The Marks of True Friendship. As human beings, we are created to be social beings. Just like our Maker, God, who exists in the fellowship of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. So when he created us in his image and likeness, we resembled him, that we cannot live without fellowship. And if you read in Genesis chapter number 2, verse 18, the Bible says, "And the Lord God said, It is not good that the man should be alone. I will make him a helpmate for him." In other words, even during creation, when sin had not started in the Garden of Eden, God saw something amiss, the loneliness of man. And therefore, he decided to make him a person whom they can fellowship together with him. However, Genesis chapter number 3 introduces us to another world that now has been interfered with by sin. And therefore, sin interfered even with the relationship of man. That is why what God had created initially to bring forth joy, happiness, and goodness in the life of man turned out to be a disaster. And even today, you agree together with me, most of the sorrows, pains, betrayals, and even sometimes even suicide is caused by the relationships that we have in life. Therefore, what should we do? Remember the word of God. 2 Timothy chapter 3 verse 16 says, "All scripture is given by inspiration of God and is profitable for doctrine," that is for teaching. Therefore, we can get the best teaching from the word of God on how to relate. how to have good friendship, how to relate, and it does not end up in sorrow, in pain, in despair. Therefore, what should we do? Since there are so many types of relationships under the sun, what we need to know is how to identify the true friendship, so that we shall not engage ourselves in relationships that will end up bringing heartaches. That's why I have entitled this message, The Mark. Because marks are used for identification. So even if there are so many relationships, as a result of our fallen nature, through the Word of God, it can direct us on how to identify the true relationship and be able to distinguish the true from the false. And therefore, I'll go direct to the Word of God in the text that we have read about Jesus. Jesus is God, and God is love. Therefore, there's nobody else who can be able to show us what love is best except Christ. And according to Vine's dictionary, Bible dictionary, it defines love or friendship as the idea of loving as well as being loved. That is the definition the Bible dictionary, W.E. Vine's dictionary, defines friendship as the idea of loving. So in friendship, there are two things, loving and as well as the sense of feeling loved. That is what completes true friendship. And the book where we have read from is the Gospel of John. And John is a very wonderful gospel writer, because John is one of the disciples of Jesus who used to lie on the chest of Jesus, very close to Jesus' heartbeat. In fact, he was very intimate with Jesus, that Jesus used to refer to him, John, the beloved. John the Beloved. And also theologians term him as the apostle of love. So he's a person who knows what he is talking about, because he has experienced love in a great way. So out of this text, there are some few things we can be able to identify out. Number one, true friendship is based on unconditional love. True friendship is based on unconditional love. That is point number one. When you are looking for true friendship, someone should not tell you, you should do this, you should do that, so that I may love you. If you read verse 1 and 2, you realize that John does not give us a background of the parents of Lazarus. He does not tell us the school he attended. He does not tell us the property that he owns. He just tells us that Lazarus and his family are friends of Jesus. Jesus loved them unconditionally, even without knowing what they own or they do not own. For true love loves you for who you are, not for what you have. Hallelujah. And the current world we are living in, I appreciate so much what the social media is doing into our lives. But one thing that comes out very clearly, it is about our status. Some of us load our status with information that is not true. I went to this university. The car besides me belongs to me. Maybe even dressings and some makeups. For what? So that we can raise the hope of those who will see us, at least they will love us. And that's why we are ending up with relationships that are hurting us. Because the person on that status is not the real person. It is a person who is trying to please men so that they can love him. But true love originates from the heart. It loves me for who I am on the inside, not for what I own or I have. And that's why Jesus loved this family, not because of anything. John does not introduce anything that Lazarus had. Therefore, stop loading your status with information that is not true. I have seen some people even say, I attended this university, knowing really that even at primary level, you do not go beyond that. Brethren, you are tempting people to enter into a relationship with you, knowing that that is not the truth. The Bible says in Proverbs chapter 31 that charms are deceptive. What the appearance, the outside appearance, can deceive you. And therefore, you end up saying, this is the man or this is the person I would like to love. Only to realize that that was the outside image. True friendship is based on who I am, not on what I have. Point number two, it says true love. If you want to know true love, it is also a two-way traffic. True love says it gives out love, and the object of its love reciprocates love to it. If I love you, you ought to love me back. Jesus loved this family, and this family loved it back. How do we know that? Because the Bible says that Jesus loved Lazarus, and so he also loved Mary and Martha. And also this family loved Jesus because they accommodated him into their house. That is how love does. And because John chapter 3 verse 16 says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, so that we may do what? In return, we may love him back. And how do we love him back? Through worship. Love is a two-way. I cannot love and you do not love back. That's why the Bible says, and I came to my own people, and my own people did not love me back. When God loved you, that's why he gave you life. That's why you are living. But it's very unfortunate. Maybe you are watching this clip and you are not born again. Remember, God has loved you, but you have not loved him back. And that is what we call worship. And how does love maintain this two-way traffic? It is what we call exclusivity. That means when there is a true friendship, then, and a genuine love, you cannot love anything else. True love excludes everything and leaves only the two of you. That is why Exodus chapter number 20 verse 3 says, thou shalt not have any other God before me, because I love you. Then you need not love anything else. Also, remember 2 Timothy chapter number 3 verse 1 says, and in those days, people will be lovers of self, lovers of money, lovers of pleasure. The problem with those times it is that people will divert their love. When God still loves them, instead of loving back, they love other things. That is what is called idol worship. Number three, the mark number three on true friendship is that true friendship is always tested. True friendship is always tested. And it is tested in times of distress or when there are challenges. That's when you can know whether you are in true friendship or not. And I'm so grateful because the time that we are going on right now, due to this corona pandemic, the time itself is so distressful. And that's how true relationships will be tested. The spouses are jobless. They have been laid off. They are not going to work. The finances or the income is limited or is not there. And these are tests of testing how strong our relationships are, how genuine our relationships are. In the Bible, we have so many examples. We have David and Jonathan. When David met a threat of death from King Saul of Israel, it is Jonathan who came to his rescue. And that's where the true covenant of Jonathan and David was bound. When David had the threat of death. Also, we have Proverbs 17, verse 17. It says that a friend loveth at all times. So, even though my husband is not bringing food at home as he used to do, if it is true love, I should continue loving him. Our friendship should continue. Even if he's not going to work, even if my wife is not working right now, I should continue loving even now. There are some of us who are separated by the downrock. We need to go on loving, because true love is tested at a time like this. Amen. I know the Lord is speaking to someone right now. That is a true mark. Number four, a true friendship. Another mark is that it adds value to a relationship. Whenever we enter into a friendship and we truly love each other, we add value to one another. That is another mark. True friendship does not pursue personal agendas. It only pursues what is of mutual benefit between the two of us. That's why, and how does it add value to our friendship? Number one, it spends time together. If really I am in true friendship with you, I should be able to sacrifice my time for you. And that's why the Bible says, God says, I'll never leave you nor forsake you. Nowadays, I have realized, even the relationship we have between spouses or between parents and their children, we have so much, we are ready to give anything, any present to anybody, but we are not ready to give our presence. True friendship gives presence, but not presence. I remember reading of a story somewhere in the social media, and it was saying of a son who could not see his father. And he told him, "Father, how much does your company pay you for 1 hour?" And he said, $100. And this little boy went gathering for that money. And when he got it, he told the father, "Can I pay you $100 so that you can spend 1 hour with me?" There are some people, there are some of us who have been so busy, and God being God, did things his own way. Maybe that's why Corona has come, so that we can spend time together with those people we love dearly, so that my wife can see me, my husbands can have time with their wives, and parents can have time with their children. So true love adds value by spending time together. Number two, it is adds value by giving wise counsel. Proverbs 27 verse 9 says that ointment or perfume rejoices the heart, so that the sweetness of a man's friend by hearty counsel or good counsel. Good friends do not misadvise others. They don't give wrong advice to their friends. They give wise counsel. What can help me? What can advance me? Where can I invest? If I am going through a bad way, it's there to correct me. That's how true friendship is all about. Number three, it enlightens. Proverbs 27:17. It says, "Iron sharpens iron, so a man sharpeneth the countenance of his friend." So a true friend will share with me, will see that he raises my knowledge, my understanding, through sharing the word of God, through sharing any positive knowledge. And also it adds value by rebuking. Proverbs 27 verse 5, "Open rebuke is better than secret love." There are some people who fear correcting their friends. Let me tell you, a rebuke is very positive if it's given by love. In Galatians chapter number 2 verse 14, it is quotes an incident where Paul meets Peter doing the wrong thing. He is discriminating some brethren in the church. And the Bible says Paul rebukes Peter, not because he hates him. It is because that's a mark of a true friendship. And number four is that true friendship is open to each other. It does not hide anything. We are living in times when people have so many secrets in their hearts, and they are still saying, we are friends. I'm husband and wife, parents and children, and so many secrets. People do not know what you own, what you do not know, own, where it is, how it is, because you are hiding each other. Remember the text we have read. Our brother, this family calls Jesus and tells him Lazarus is ill because Jesus is ready. They do not hide Jesus anything. What is happening in their homes? They are ready to share that information with Jesus. John 15, 15 says, I will not call you servants because servants do not know any information except duty. But I'll call you friends because friends share information. But I have called you friends, for all things that I have heard, I'll tell you. Friends do not hide anything from each other. So if you see somewhere where secrets are being, there are so much, there is no true friendship. And number six, it is that true friendship risks on behalf of the other. It is ready to risk. The Bible says in John 15, verse 13, greater love has no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends. Going back to our text, the disciples tell Jesus, are you ready to go back to Bethany? And you remember what happened to you in Jerusalem? And there are some guys who are begging for your blood. Are you ready to go? Jesus said, I'm ready to risk my life for the sake of my friend Lazarus. True friendship risks. Jesus died on the cross because of our sins. The Bible says in John 15, 13, greater love had no man than this, that a man laid down his life for his friends. That's what Jesus did. Do you lay your life for the sake of your friends? We are living in a world of so many selfish people who are not ready to lay anything for the sake of their friends. True friendship risks. There is a quoting that says, no distance of place or lapse of time can lessen the friendship of those who are thoroughly persuaded of each other's worth. There is nothing that you can withhold to a true friend. And last but not least, true friendship is long lasting. Get me well? True love or true friendship is long lasting. The relation of Jesus and Lazarus could not be cut by mere death. The Bible says in John 13, verse 1, Jesus raises Lazarus from the dead so that their friendship can continue. Remember also, Jesus loves us so much that he will not leave us on the grave because he loves us so much. The friendship that can cease, it means it had not initially started. The friendship that can cease has never been real. That is what Saint Jerome said. And today, brethren, our friendship should last. Our friendship should go beyond. Romans 8:35, the Bible says, who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation, distress, persecution, famine, nakedness, peril, or sword, and I add my own corona, will it separate us from our God? No, true friendship is long lasting. May the Lord bless you so much as you ponder upon those points, those 7 points that bear the marks of a true friendship. May the Lord bless you so much. Be blessed. Until next time, goodbye. And goodbye. Shalom, shalom.